Elasticsearch is the search engine of choice for companies like Uber, Udemy, Slack, Shopify, and many other multi-million dollar companies. Never heard of it? Well, I guarantee you that you have used Elasticsearch before and probably didn't even know it. So what's so great about Elasticsearch? Well, it can search multiple databases in an instant. When a client runs a search, the last thing they want to do is wait around forever for unrelated and useless search results. Search engines like Elasticsearch or Solr give you the capability to search tons of data very quickly and get relevant results. Hi, I'm Caleb from Sematext, and today we are going to deploy Elasticsearch inside of a Docker container. Now, this video assumes that you already have a basic understanding of Docker. If you don't, that's fine. Check out some of our other resources about Docker to get a basic understanding, or just follow along. Or if you're a pro looking for the best consulting for Elasticsearch, check out Sematext. We literally wrote the book on this subject. First things first, what is Elasticsearch? Elasticsearch is a powerful search and analytics engine. With Elasticsearch, you can search millions and millions of datasets, whether textual, numerical, geospatial, even structured or unstructured datasets. Elasticsearch is owned by a company called Elastic. Elasticsearch used to be open source software, but as of version 7.11, the software is no longer under the Apache 2.0 license. There's a lot of drama there, not worth going into, but just know this. In this demonstration, I'll be using version 7.10. That version is the most recent version that is still under the Apache 2.0 license, so it's open source and it works just fine. If you really want an open source solution that's maintained, check out Solr. It's one of Elasticsearch's open source competitors. So why do this? Why put Elasticsearch inside of a Docker container? Now that's a legitimate question. Full disclosure here, Elasticsearch will perform a bit better on Baremetal machines than in a container. But how much better? An IBM research report shows that containers run very similar to Baremetal and far outperform KVMs. The average difference between Baremetal and containerized application is less than 1%, more like 0.8%. This is mainly due to Docker and other containerizing tools being able to share the host's underlying resources better than a virtual machine can. The main drawback in performance comes from Docker's networking. Docker creates addresses for each of its containers and has its own network address translator to look up the container's address, just like a DNS, but for Docker's networks. There is a workaround, however. In Docker, you can now use the host network stack when running containers. You will then get near identical performance to the native app. Moral of the story is this, do not use VMs for Elasticsearch, and the performance difference between containerized applications and Baremetal applications is very negligible. So for some, this extra setup and configuration and potential drawbacks might be a deal breaker, but consider this. You get so many other benefits from using containers, like your containers run anywhere agnostically. You have a consistent testing environment from development, testing, deployment, and even scaling. Containers also keep your app consistent, which limits configuration drifts, and you don't have to worry about over-provisioning your apps. And even better, once containerized, you can use container orchestration software like Kubernetes and automate the maintenance process. If that less than 1% drop in performance isn't a real issue for you, then let's jump right into how to put Elasticsearch on Docker. Obviously, you're going to need Docker, so get that if you don't already have it. Also, for your containers, you will need at least 4 GB of memory for this software to run decently. First, create a file and call it docker-compose.yaml. Now, technically, you can do all this in the command line interface, but that's totally a pain, and it's up to you if you want to do that. But I highly recommend just creating a compose file. You can find this YAML file down below that I'm going to be using, but I highly recommend that you type it out yourself and follow along. Next, with our compose file, we want to list the version. The version type tells Docker which version of Docker Compose you are using. There are some differences in syntax between versions, so just be aware of these differences. Not everything from previous versions are cross-compatible. I'll use the latest version, version 3. But be responsible and check the differences in syntax and functions if yours is a newer one. Now, let's get the Elasticsearch Docker image, version 7.10. Why version 7.10? Because we like open source solutions. In fact, that's the whole reason we don't just pull the latest version and call it a day. Post version 7.10, Elasticsearch switched their licensing. This version, version 7.10, is under the Apache 2.0 license, so yeah, you can use it however you want. It's open source and free. Now, let's copy and paste that a few times to create some nodes, and we will also want these guys to be able to talk to each other, so let's link them together. Like I said earlier, Docker uses its own network and its own ports for the containers, which are different from the Docker host's port. If you want to expose a port on your system, you have to declare it specifically. Now, data storage. In case you didn't know, Docker containers are stateless, meaning that when the container is gone, so is all the data that was inside of it. This is Bob. Bob decided to keep his data inside of a container, and when the container inevitably crashed, Bob lost millions of dollars worth of data. Bob suddenly found himself with a lot more free time to rethink his decisions. Don't be like Bob, and don't store the data inside of the container. Use a volume. If you want your data and indexes to be stateful, be sure to output the data into a volume, like so. We also want Kibana so that we can interact with and look into our clusters. Same deal as Elasticsearch. We want version 7.10, and then we're going to link them up, like so. That should be good. Docker Compose up, there it is. Your very own containerized version of Elasticsearch and Kibana. All the networking should be good, containers should be talking to each other. Finally, you need to monitor all of this stuff. You need to monitor your host machine, all the Docker containers, the Elasticsearch nodes, the instances, the network, the host machine resources, everything. Monitor everything with one easy installation of Sematext Agent. There is a freemium version out there, and you can go and try it out today for free. Link for that down in the description below. If typing's not your style, the complete Docker Compose file is available down in the description below as well. If you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe, as we will be diving deeper into this topic in the next video. Stay safe, keep monitoring, and I will see you in the next one.